const versus let versus var. These are all ways to define variables in JavaScript. Const and let were introduced in ES6, but var has been with us since the beginning. Let's go over their differences. Const is for values that never change. For instance, if I have a const pi, and I set it equal to 3.14, and then if I want to set pi again until to 1, well, let me run this. If you look over on the side, on the console, you'll see uncaught type error, assignment to constant variable. So I can't assign a constant to a constant variable. However, if I clear my console, and then I change this const to a var, and then I run it again, no error. Just to prove that I was running it, we'll add a console.log. And you should see a 1 show up in the console. Now let's go over let. Let is for block level variables. So, for example, if I have a for loop, and then for loops are always in blocks. Blocks are anything with these curly braces. So let variables, you can see I assigned a let variable in the for loop, and I am going to console.log that variable that's defined with let. And as you can see, if I run this, it's going to say 0, 1, 2. So it's locking that variable I assigned with let. Now, if I try to console.log that variable before the for loop, and then we try running this, you can see there's going to be an error. Same if I take this, if I copy this, and then put it after the for loop, and we run this again, let me clear the console, and I'm going to run this again, and you'll see that there's another error. So when you define something with let, it's only available within the block that's defined. So we are now going to go over to var, and you'll see how that's different. Var is for variables available to the entire function, or if it's not within a function, to the entire program. I'm actually just going to copy this whole thing and paste it down here, and I am doing this with an encode pin, but I've set the keys to be similar to Sublime Text. So if I just double click this I, I'm going to press Control D and it's going to select each I, and then I'm going to press J to switch them all to J. Now this let, I'm going to switch to var, because we're going to define the variable J with var instead of let. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to comment out this console.log and let. We're going to run this, and as you can see, even though this console.log is below the for loop, it's still able to log it. Now, if I take this copy this console.log and put one before the for loop, the other one is after the for loop, so if I put this one before the for loop and run this again, you'll see in the console, undefined. Remember before, if I assigned it with let, it said error. Now it's showing undefined. That means it knows the variable exists, because when you define something with var, it will be available even before the time that you assigned it. So it knows it exists, but it hasn't been assigned yet. So it's showing undefined because J does exist, but it just hasn't been defined to any number yet. So those are basically the differences between const, var, and let. And in future videos, I may go into even more detail. Well, thanks for watching. My name is Beau Carnes. Don't forget to subscribe, and remember, use your code for good.